2016 is off to a busy start with headline-grabbing exchange mergers and acquisitions, an ongoing focus on regulation, and the continued search for growth. John Lothian News sat down with key exchange executives to get their thoughts on the changing landscape and what's on their priority list for the rest of the year.
As I look back at 2015, it's a very, I would call it a milestone year for CME. We had record volume. Five of the six asset classes saw some growth from 2014, which in and of itself was also a great year for us. We continue to gain traction in what I'll call the main focus of the strategy of the company: globalization, futurization, and electronification, and specifically electronification of options. When you think about the investments that we made on the technology front, there were quite a few of them, but I think the most prominent ones relate to what I'll call the future of CME Group: big data, quantum computing, blockchain technology, and clearing and settlement systems that, while not applicable in its entirety now, are giving us great insights into how the future might unfold for both ourselves and our client. It gives us an opportunity to take this viewpoint, bring it to our clients, and develop solutions that create a capital-efficient world for our clients. And then we also, very importantly, looked at the cost equation, which has been a pain point for all of our clients, from the client's point of view, and working intently and working very hard to help them solve some of these issues surrounding price and surrounding cost. This cost approach has allowed us to do several things: expanded our client base, deepened their participation in more than just one or two asset classes, which some of them have been doing, and brought them solutions that up to this point in time they did not have, and they had to work on the OTC side, with the OTC side becoming as perilous as it is, and the bank credit lines being not what they used to be. The choices for these customers shrink. And so if you look ahead, and all the work that we started doing a few years ago will bear, I think, significant fruit for us, because we're not looking to sell futures or options, we're looking to sell risk management solutions to our client base. From our point of view, understanding some of the pain points that our FCMs have, for example, and helping them meet that by structuring certain of the products and services that we sell them in a different way would make sense to many of our clients. We're taking in a lot of input from them, understanding clearly what is restricting the ability to do business right now, and working to solve those issues. But they all have different issues. The prop shops and the HFTs have a different set of issues. The banks have a completely different set of issues. The leverage ratio issue that we have in the marketplace is not helping them. And so the very reason that we started to have the clearing requirement was to incentivize OTC trades, yet the rules are disincentivizing them. This is an issue we must solve. If you look at all the globalization activity that we have had in just over the last year, and we've seen significant rates of growth, China has been something that we have at CME have been talking about for a long, long time. We had record revenue coming from China last year. We ended up the year with very strong volume coming from China. We began the year with equally strong volume coming from Asia. Europe has not been a slouch too. Europe has been performing extremely well for us. So this year, in the first 2 months of this year, the average daily volume coming out of Europe is 3.2 million contracts, which is higher than most of the exchanges in Europe in their entirety, right? And the volume coming from our Asian business is a shade under 700,000 contracts a day. Both of these represent growth rates in excess of 30%. That's encouraging for us, and that's not just a static client base that's trading more, that's an expanding client base that is buying into the capital efficient story.